Good morning, Tube.
Welcome back to another daily edition of Big Al's Barber Vlogs. Today is Friday, boys and girls. Today is Friday. It is right now about 8:25. Headed to the shop. We open at 8:30. Luckily, I only live 5 minutes away from where I work. So today, guys, I want to talk a little bit about what happened yesterday. Yesterday, me and Tone worked by ourselves. What I want to talk to you guys about is I want to talk to you about a service that I did yesterday. I did a shave on a gentleman that came in, a new customer. And it's not the first time I've used the high-end shave product that I purchased maybe a week or 2 weeks ago from the Art of Shaving. They have Art of Shaving is a store that they have at the mall. And I'm sure they're nationwide. And if they're not nationwide, you can order it on from Amazon. But the Art of Shaving, I use this this product that they have. What I bought at the mall was I bought the shave pre-shave oil, that I bought the shave cream, and it's high end because it's expensive. You know, the shave cream was $25 and the shave oil was $25. And then I should have bought that day the aftershave. But I didn't. I went cheap and I didn't want to buy it. And I should have just bought the whole kit. They had a kit for $120 and I didn't want to spend the money. I spent $50 on the shave cream and the shave oil. I should have bought the other stuff and I didn't. So I ended up ordering it later. So yesterday was the first day I actually used it. I actually used a shave brush with a little cup, put the shave cream first. What I did is first I applied the shave oil. Then I applied the shave cream. Then I gave him a hot lather. Then I gave him a hot towel. Okay. After I gave them the hot towel, I lathered them up. And once I lathered them up, then I shaved them. And I have to say that customer said that was the best shave he ever got. It was incredible. And this guy, man, I'm not even lying, guys. When I cut his beard down, because what I did is I cut his beard down first to see what his bristle and what everything looked like. And his bristle was so tough. And I was already thinking, like, damn, this is going to be a tough shave, you know? Because you could tell when a person has real strong bristle or they have real soft bristles. Soft bristles come off easier than strong bristles. So strong bristles, you really, really have to treat it before you shave it in order for the bristles to get nice and soft so that when you go, it just comes off like, oh, man. And I'm not even lying, guys. It came off like cream. It was like shaving cream off. And once I did that, I shaved them. I went down and up. And once I got done with that, then I applied another hot towel on him. And once I applied the other hot towel, I cleaned them all up. And then I applied the aftershave that I purchased from the Art of Shaving. And I'm just giving you guys a little preview. I'm actually going to do a review on these products because I think they're important for us to try to use them. Because, guys, the end result was incredible. I'm not even lying. He said himself that it was the best shave he ever gotten. And I asked him if he had ever gotten a straight razor shave. He said it had been over 10 years since he had gotten one. But he said that definitely it was the best shave that he ever got, you know. And we had some good convo while I was doing the service. And you know, I gave him I call it my spill, but it's my story about, you know, why I became a barber and about my story about my family, how I'm a third generation barber. My daughter's fourth generation. She works for me and it's a family business. And, you know, we've been in business already for 10 years. And my grandfather had his own barbershop and, you know, my uncle had his own barbershop. So it kind of runs in our family. I gave him the whole spill and, you know, and I know I won that customer over. I did. I know I did. He is going to come back, you know. But, you know, just upping my game and my shave, it made it easier, number one. It made it better, number two. And, yeah, it's a little bit more expensive for me to give that shave. But eventually, I'm going to add that to my menu of services, you know. And I'm gonna do what I'm already planning on doing is doing some kind of I'm gonna do my homework on it, of course, and it's gonna be a presentation type service. But I'm gonna do a presidential shave where it's gonna be a $50 shave, you know, $50 shave, and it's gonna consist of four hot towels and a massage, and I'm gonna do the whole facial thing. I'm gonna really up my game on the shave thing, you know. And just imagine if it's $50, guys, and it, you know, you get a couple a week, you know, and I mean, $50 for one service, that's great. You know, like, who, you know, even if it takes me an hour to do it, that's $50 an hour. You're like, who doesn't want to earn that? You know what I mean? Think about that, guys. Think about upping your game on some of your services, you know. You up your game on your service, especially for you guys that are booth rental. Hey, guys, if you're just offering a flat, haircut, kids' haircut. You know, like, come on, you got to up your game. If you're paying for a service to do appointments, then you should have various services on there. That way, you know, it's like a customer goes to a menu. Sometimes when they see a steak, there's different types of steaks, different prices. You know, you gotta, you know, you get to pick the type of steak that you want. It's the same thing with your services. They get services, they want to pick a variety of services. Maybe they want the upper grade of the service, and you have to provide that. But that's where you know, marketing yourself comes in, and making sure that you're getting all the right services on your menu. But no, I'm still learning about that myself. But you know, it's a start, and I just like the fact that the customer enjoyed the service the most. You know, to me, I felt proud at the end. Like, all right, yeah, I did a good job on him. And you know what? His skin felt incredible, guys. I'm not even lying. It felt incredible. That product smells so good. He felt his face, and his face felt so smooth. He goes, I don't think I've ever gotten a shave like that. So with that compliment alone, it was worth it. But I'm headed to the shop. I'm almost there already. That's how close I live, guys. I could talk all the way to the shop. But I'm headed there now and get started on this day, guys. Today's going to be busy. I have probably, I'm assuming I'm going to have 4 barbers there today. But we'll see. So I'm going to head down there right now, get started on this day. You guys have a blessed day. I hope you guys are grinding hard and making some money.
You better turn up. You better be there when I shake. Watch me rocking if I can't stop. If I should fall, just go ahead. Go and catch me, baby. Ooh, I live it. That's my choo-choo, choo-choo.
That's it for today. This Friday is over. It is right now almost 7 o'clock. Ended up being a pretty late day. We ended up getting stuck here. Super busy day, guys. Super busy day. Thank goodness and thank God, actually, that J-Lo came in today and helped us out. She ended up coming into work, so that helped out a lot because, you know, she's hooking them up. She's knocking out those haircuts. So this Friday is officially over, guys. Just to reflect a little bit about what we talked about earlier this morning, we were talking about doing the shaves and everything, guys. I'm going to do that review for you guys on the Artist Shaving Shave Products. Oh, my God. Guys, this stuff is incredible. I gave Tony a sample so he could try it out. I'm encouraging him more to use that stuff. And he said, like, oh, man, that stuff is crazy. It's crazy good. Crazy good. So I'm going to try it on a couple. I've only done two shaves with it so far. So once I get a little bit better with it, and I try it out a little bit more, I'm going to try to make a video on it, and when I do, that way I can post it and show you guys. Plus, I'm going to review that product. That product is incredible. Plus, right now, I'm also working on doing that 10 on the 1919 review. Working on it. I got a lot of clips for it now, so just basically got to all put it all together. So, I'll probably be dropping that probably this coming Tuesday. So, keep your eye out for that, guys. Also, guys, I appreciate everybody who's been, you know, participating and asking questions and everything. You know, to me,
it makes this doing these videos a lot much better when people interact with me and ask me questions and give me things to talk about, and you know what I mean? Because, you know, although I'm running this business here and I'm here every single day and I'm trying to give you guys my perspective on everything, but the questions always help out. So I appreciate that, guys, and I appreciate everybody who's watching and everybody who's participating. You know, hey, I'm only here to help out and give you guys my perspective on this business and being an entrepreneur and helping out. And there's, I know, I have people out there that are watching that they aren't even barbers and are watching and taking my advice. And I appreciate that, Paul, especially you, buddy. Thank you very much. But hey, guys, with that being said, that's it for today. Tomorrow's Saturday. I got a couple appointments in the morning. Let me tell you guys a little bit about my appointment thing today. So today I had a set of appointments. It was two father sons, one back to back. The first set showed up a little late. He showed up actually like about a half hour late. So I tried to knock him out anyway. It didn't work out. So what I ended up doing was I asked the other customer of mine, I asked him, do you mind if I do the father before I do you guys? And he was, yeah, he's cool. Ishmael is really cool. So he didn't say, of course, he said, go for it, do it. So, but, you know, that was my first kind of like time where my appointments kind of bumped into each other. Let me know what you guys do on situations like that, because this is all new. Appointments are new to me, so I need your guys' advice to that. But with that being said, guys, this is it for today. Tomorrow, Saturday, another day, I'll be back, you know? But, hey, guys, thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys mañana.